Thank you very much, Michael. As I said, I know there is a problem. I mean, very often, according to my experience, I guess your experience in that particular point could be similar. Educational chess, given mainly by school teachers, and extracurricular chess, given mainly by chess instructors, and so on, competitive chess, are not very well connected as a normal situation. What can we do to improve that?
Well, I believe it is connected, because the ideal format to implement chess in education is to introduce all elements. It's chess in curriculum, chess in after school or elective, and it could be preschool, meaning chess could be, as we call in the States, and that we implemented sunrise chess, and lunchtime program chess. So therefore, if schools that we were working with and schools that implemented this format in the States, they are more successful in competitive chess as well. So therefore, I believe that this is exactly the goal that chess in European Union and education should pursue. Mm-hmm. And as an example, I can tell you that schools that have chess in the curriculum from even in second grade or second and third grade, it's good enough, because these kids learn chess as they learn how to read or how to write. They learn comprehensive language, whether it would be English, Spanish, or any other languages. And they become actually feeders to your after-school program and elective program. Afterwards, you can introduce them to competitive elements of the game and to competitive chess. So therefore, this bridge already been built by us in the United States. So therefore, here in Europe, as I always say, there are many bridges already been built over the Danube River. So you just need good educational tools to navigate them. So you need GPS to move your teachers to get through.
Yes, especially because we have to try to manage this in all countries. And actually, currently, this is not the situation. But tell me, what is the best partner to work with in order to build that bridge? Local federations or private companies working on educational chess?
Whatever works in each particular country, because there is no one recipe universally for the world. In the United States, we have collaboration of private entities, of nonprofit organizations, and eventually with state and national chess federation. But when we're talking about bringing chess from non-competitive elements in education to competitive, so, as I said, it's already been implemented, and implemented by, as I mentioned, nonprofit organizations like Asparov Chess Foundation and some others, as well as small private enterprises. When we implemented this, we introduced competitive elements within the schools. So first, we introduced these tournaments, as we call it, training tournaments within the schools, then inter-schools, then open tournaments. Only after that, they go to play at the state level and then national level, which are under auspices of the state and respectively national federation. But without collaboration of all above mentioned organizations and coaches and educators, it won't be possible to bring thousands of kids to participate in scholastic chess tournaments like we have. Let's say Kasparov Chess Foundation created a series of regional tournaments that we conduct during normal times, not during the COVID, in New York, Chicago, Baltimore, and in California, and we call it Greater New York Scholastic Championship, Greater Chicago, Greater Mid-Atlantic, and Greater California. Mm-hmm. It brings all together probably around 2,500 scholastic players, and it's individual and team school event that all schools that have chess in the programs eager to send their teams in different sections. So therefore, we provide this ground for kids to learn and to compete as well.
Mm-hmm. Finally, in your first answer, you mentioned lunchtime chess. That reminds me a conversation with you in 2018 in New York, when you were telling me about the chess for early birds. I found that very interesting. Can you please explain that?
Well, early birds, we call it sunrise chess. It's a program when kids can come to school before first period starts. So let's say school doors are open, let's say from 7:30 in the morning, but first class starts 8:15. So from 7:30, kids can come and play. And usually it's less instructional, but rather play games for them under supervision of the instructor. When we're talking about the lunchtime program, it's more like for middle and high school students, when middle school club or high school club formed, and especially in upper school, these clubs are formed by students themselves. So therefore, initiative comes from them. And they take their lunch, and at some dedicated classroom or corner, they gather. And again, it could be under our supervision or under supervision of the president of this chess club that been elected in high school by their own peers.
Mm-hmm. Just one small detail. One of them, coming back to the early birds chess, I guess that one of the very good points of that is that first time in the morning, children are very fresh. So it's more effective to teach chess that time, right?
Some of them fresh, some of them still sleepy. So, but you definitely will wake them up. But they will be ready fully at the first period in the school for other subjects.
It's a very intelligent way of waking them up, I think, right?
Well, trust me, when they have already chess pieces in their hands, they're waking up.
As I told Jerry Nash before, and Fernando Moreno as well, having in mind how influential is the USA for the rest of the world, please keep going. You are doing a very great job. Thank you very much, Michael.
Thank you too, and my pleasure to be here. Thanks.
Thank you.